carrinho para chata para cá. Father God, thank you for this heavenly language.
Pela que ele não mandou deixar o moço ele que toda santíssima.
Por toda a escrita, por toda a escrita.
What you're hearing is commonly referred to as speaking in tongues, but it's not. It's just gibberish. Nowhere in the Bible are we told to pray like this. In fact, there's not one verse in the Bible that encourages praying in tongues. What about the book of Acts? Well, the gift of tongues was given to share the gospel so everyone could hear it in their own language. What about 1 Corinthians 14? Well, it's there Paul says, if I pray in a tongue, my spirit prays, but my mind is unfruitful. What am I to do? I will pray with my spirit, but I will pray with my mind also. He doesn't encourage praying in tongues. He's discouraging the practice. But verse 39 says, don't forbid speaking in tongues. Right, and the context is to prophesy, not private prayer. What is the gift of tongues for? It is a sign not for believers, but for unbelievers, to hear the gospel spoken in their own language. Read every passage on tongues with that understanding. It's not a prayer language, and it's especially not incoherent babbling. Jesus said, when you pray, do not heap up empty phrases as the pagans do. Pray then like this, Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we have also forgiven our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Jesus prayed clear prayers, and so should we, when we understand the text.